Some of the Missouri wineries we visited have a house dog, some have a house cat, but I found one that has a house swan. I kid you not. Right over there, if you look closely, you will see Heath the swan, and he rules the roost at Defiance Ridge Vineyard in Defiance, Missouri. And by the way, his picture graces both bottles of Vignole, red and white, and I can't wait to go up there and try them out. Chuck Gillentine, you're the owner, CEO here at Defiance Ridge. You know, when you walk in here, it's a big place, but it still feels very quaint. What's the history of this place?
You know, the Germans, when they founded the area in the 1800s, it's a winemaking area. You know, Missouri was like the second largest state of producing wine back in the day. So they figured out how to make wine on the beautiful Missouri River, the bluffs, the soil. It's a great place to make wine, and you know, lots of it's made around here.
Yeah, and you said that the rockiness is perfect for the grapes. I never really realized how much the grapes like that sort of environment.
They love stone. You know, grapes love to get in between things and grow very, very, very deep. All your smells and your flavors develop from that limestone and dirt and everything just helps into making a great wine.
What about the history of this beautiful house?
1899 it was built. Defiance has a long, huge history with the Katy Trail next to it, and this house has been here a long time. We purchased it 2 years ago, and it's more of our event area for brides and this and that to change in. Our kitchen's located in it, but it's definitely an old home.
This patio is very conducive to sitting and relaxing and sipping wine. How many people can you seat here?
Well, inside and out, probably 600.
Okay.
And coming up weeks, we'll hit that, I think.
Okay, and you are open 7 days a week for lunch?
7 days a week. We open at our hours 11 to 5, weekdays. Weekends and Sunday, Saturday and Sunday, same thing.
And by the way, they can heat it up out on the other patio that we're going to show you in the wintertime, so don't be afraid of January, February.
Please,
be here.
Don't be afraid of that. That's when we need you.
It's when they need you, and this is a great place to come. All right, so you're very much a farm-to-table sort of a restaurant.
We deal with a lot of local purveyors, a cattle grower, a shrimp farm, very local shrimp farm.
I noticed.
And a mushroom, local mushroom guy who's fantastic.
Okay, good to know. All right, I would like to go look at more of your event space because I understand you do live music almost every single weekend.
Every Saturday and Sunday, 1 to 4.
I want to see the stage.
Okay.
So check out this stage back here. This is the perfect setup, and you've got a lot of umbrellas out here, so you can really enjoy the weather.
A lot of shade for people to dance in. You know, it's you really can. When it's fall time, it's just gorgeous here.
It's gorgeous in the summertime as well.
It's really pretty.
Oh, I'm sure the fall is to die for around here. Okay, talk about the music that you have. So this is every weekend.
Every weekend, 1 to 4, Saturday and Sundays. It's all local talent, some really good local talent, and names that draw pretty well, and you know they we try to keep the same 8-10 bands in line and just rotate them around.
I said I wanted for Chuck to wow me. Check this out. What is this? Is your best seller?
Yeah, this is our farmer's board. It's a lot of local stuff. Great charcuterie board. Meats are local. Some of the pickling we do in house. Make mustards and this and that. But it. We sell a lot of these boards.
I can see why. I don't even know where to start with this, but I'm pretty sure I could polish it off all by myself.
You know what? It's a lot of stuff there.
Don't tell anybody if I do. Okay, let's taste the wine. Where are we starting?
Okay, so our first wine is our Vidal Blanc. And Vidal is a local wine. You know, it's there's a lot of growing in the state. I think it's the third or fourth most produced varietal in the state. Mm-hmm. You get mineral tones, you get lemon. It's bone dry, but it's got a nice, clean kind of a mineral aftertaste too.
Okay, let's move to the next one. What's this one?
Okay, the next one is our most popular wine. It's our Dry Vignot. It's named after our Swan Heath, and it has got an incredible nose. It's just a beautiful wine. It's got a little bit of sugar in it, not much, but it's still classified dry.
A little bit sweeter, but still dry. And it's not a sweet wine by any stretch. Wow, I like this one even better.
Now, this is a fantastic food wine.
My goodness, this is good.
Yeah.
Okay, so this is, it's going to be tough to put this one down, but I guess I have to.
Its flavor's peachy, it's nectarine, it's it's our most popular wine.
I don't know which is my favorite, but because I kind of am leaning toward this one, this is the best seller, probably for good reason.
I agree with that.
Will you join me in the farmers board
here?
Sure
will, yeah.
Okay, Chuck, to you and Defiance Ridge.
Thank you very much.
Cheers.
Okay, cheers. Thank you.
This place is awesome.